Actually, my life has changed for the better with Mrs. Gordy because in terms of the partner, and she's a friend. We have hot debates from time to time. It took 7 years to get engaged. She's asked me, when will I marry her? Well, I reckon it'll take 7 years to get married. So obviously that's going to change. There was green, what would you call them?
Deli curtains.
Curtains, the styrofoam thing. Well, you can see that's got changed.
That's got changed because they're cats. They're not cats.
They are cats.
No, they're not cats. They have seen you being with cars. I've got something to say. My friends are not cats. Russell?
Anyway, so many things have changed, but for the better. And so I'd like you to charge your glasses and wish me happy birthday.
Happy birthday! Happy.
Man and Teresa for travelling up. Yeah, I know it's a big commitment for you two to come, and it's nice to have you here on my birthday party. And friends who have travelled with us there. And I'd like to thank Peter, who's the chef.
Pete's
been a wonder, you know. I've got to talk a little bit about him because in turn I was looking for a warehouse person to work at my warehouse. Anyway, I had to burn out. Anyway, Peter had phoned in and eventually arrived in at my door and said, you know, I'm Peter and I'd like a job. And I asked him a few questions and he said, well, you've got the job, eh? Mainly because in turn he had, you know, a lot of people put a big flashy resume in front of you, and there's a lot of bullshit that I can tell you. Resumes are full of bullshit. You've got to read through a lot of things to which in turn the super truth. Pete just arrived up into 15 feet. And what I found out was he's a very good chef, and he's been an asset to me in many ways. But in turn, I thank you very much for doing the work for me.
Yeah, well done.
Thank you. Thank you. And happy birthday.
So what else do I need to say? Well, I guess I've got to tell you that Pauline moved in March, which was Easter, and thank you Philip and Craig and Lockie who came up to help move Pauline in. Philip and Craig and Lockie helped me move into here, which I've got to tell you, I wouldn't have done it without them. I managed to pack up most of the house, which I sold in Cottesloe to move here. But in turn, when it came to the shed, God, the stuff I had. And thank God Craig and Philip came up and then helped me to move in. And God, I was never going to get it done.
Thank God you had a bigger shed.
It's still not big enough.
So the reason of moving to Wanneroo was because Pauline and I wanted to make a life together.
Wow.
And so Cottesloe just wasn't going to do it. It's a much smaller property, as you all know. And so we contemplated different decisions. And so I think we found the property here.
Don't
you,
right?
Yeah, well, look, yeah, it's true. Women buy houses, don't they? And so, I must admit, I enjoy living here. It's a nice big property to put everything I need to do everything I want to do. And so, naturally, the cats came with Claudine, hence the cat outfit. Because it's, I had just one cat, which I inherited from my daughter Chelsea, with his name Mango. He was never meant to be with me, but in turn Chelsea came and begged me to take the cats. And,
as I do.
And so she could bring it down. I said, when you leave, it goes with you. But when she left, the cat stayed. And as cats go, you know, they really know how to wiggle their way into your heart. And so he became a good mate. So, you know, he's a bit of a character. But when Pauline came, she came with cats and a ready-made family. So now we've got quite a family of cats. Pauline loves to save the strays. So we've had many debates about this because I just said that we'd just shoot them all. However, she has managed to save a lot of these cats, and they're quite characters. We have new addition to our family is Smokey. Normally with a group of people, he doesn't come home.
So, how many cats you got, Dave? Five. We had about 10. No, we had 6. We have now.
Five. Not enough.
No, I know. No.
Well, I think it's enough. Yes.
Yes.
Well enough.
Yes.
But anyway, look, I'd like to thank you all for coming.
No. Yeah. Happy birthday, David.
I'm incredibly sorry. Forgive my voice, it's a bit cracky.
She has a cold.
I'm incredibly proud of my dad. I think he's a person that just never gives up. He's always there when you need him. I think that he's a great. I'm so blessed to have him as my dad.
Love. Yeah.
As you all know, I'm sure you've encountered how real my dad is. What's white is white, and what's black is black. And that's the way it is. And I love that about my dad, because you always know where he stands on things. And yeah, I just really love how he's committed to people, and you know, he values people as well, like. And he'll always show up for them, even if there are some problems. I've found that you always turn up. And yeah, Dad, I really love you. And there's a time in my life where I didn't.
That's part of life.
I'm sorry, I'm giving the silent treatment and not show up, not come and visit on the weekend. And my dad still loved me through it. And
yeah.
Still tried to reach out to me as much as he could. And I always loved that you still made it up there, even though I showed you the tough shoulder.
That's nice.
Oh, I'm very proud of you too.
Yay! That's love. That is true love. Yeah, I had a boyfriend.
Oh, this is a dangerous thing. All right, so Tom Cruise is a boss. Okay. Right. So, what do you say about somebody that's a healer? Like, Dad is somebody that. Well, my dad is somebody that's naturally wants to help people, and that's shown ever since my childhood, really. My dad will always be there telling me, this is how you change your oil. This is how you repair your car. okay, thanks, Dad. hey, this is how your liver works. You need to take a hepatic detox, and this is how you need to counteract, what is it? One can of Coke, you need to have 20 glasses of water at a pH of 10.
32 glasses.
So, naturally, in my time. So naturally, in my childhood, I was scared away from stuff like Coca-Cola. I never drank one for a long, 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 long time. Not to mention, I can't ever remember all this stuff. But actually, Dad wants to help every single one of us. Like, you know, he generally tries to help people all the time. He tries to teach people, and he is very passionate about the things that he cares about. Like, I'm sure every one of us has had a discussion on health and whatnot. Yeah. Yeah. That's because that, you know, that's because my dad is A, passionate, B, he really does want to help you. Like, he generally wants, you know, passionate about trying to make your lives better. And that's a wonderful quality in a person.
Yes.
That's always been there to be able to, like, you know, he's always been there for me. And whenever I'm in a rough situation, he's usually the one to help me through it. And that's, you know, definitely
that's
a wonderful quality in a person.
Cheers! Cheers!
How did you go from shearing sheep to what you are now?